Praise the Lord, everybody. Pastor Nick here with another devotion from the book of Psalm. So glad you can join me this morning and every morning at 7 a.m. as we continue to journey through the scriptures, try to experience God through his word, his power through the scriptures. And we're so glad, again, you can join us this morning. If you haven't done so, please like, share, and subscribe. Comment, of course. Let somebody know that we're on today as we continue to worship the Lord and continue to go through this particular book. Of course, follow me on my platforms if you can. The information is on the screen. Follow the church and follow Bishop. All right, we're in Psalm 134. And Psalm 134 is the conclusion of the Psalms of Ascent. So the past few days, we've been going through the ascending Psalms as the people were pilgrimaging up to Jerusalem, going up to see God. He was shaping their thought process as they were coming to see him. So when we come to God, we have to look at it like we're ascending to where he is, even though God's always present, but it's what we're trying to show you. And the mindset that we have, that when we come to him, we're looking up. When we come to him, we understand we're going up, trusting and believing in him, worshiping him, understanding that we're coming to his presence, coming to his house with thanksgiving and with praise. And Psalm 134 concludes this particular section of these Psalms of Ascent. And he says, come, bless the Lord, all you servants of the Lord. It's an invitation. When God calls us to him, he's inviting us to bless him. All right. All the servants of the Lord. He's not some of us, but all of us coming to bless him. And when we come with the frame of mind coming to celebrate him, worship him, and bless him, who stand by night in the house of the Lord. So when we come with the framework to bless him. He says, verse 2, lift up your hands to the holy place and bless the Lord. So when we come not only blessing him, we come with hands lifted, because hands lifted is our hands of surrender, hands of acknowledgement. I lift my hands. I believe also in when they talk about lifting hands, it's one of those things where it's an image of me taking my heart and lifting it up to God. So when I lift my hands, I'm lifting myself to him. I'm lifting up hands of worship, and I'm showing God my complete surrender of him. Right where you are, lift your hands and surrender yourself to him. Because the act of surrender is an act of worship and the act of praise. Present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Lift yourself to the Lord. He says, may the Lord, maker of heaven and earth, bless you from Zion. When we come to him, we come to bless him. We come with hands lifted, surrendering ourselves, showing him that we belong to him, and bless the Lord. May the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth, bless you from Zion. That's going to be the content of our prayer today. May the Lord, the maker of heaven, bless you from Zion. Bless you from his holy place. May the Lord do so. Come on, let's pray. Father, I thank you again for this moment. We appreciate you for this time. We thank you, Lord, for your loving kindness, for your tender mercies. We appreciate you today for all that you have done. And we thank you for who you are to us. And we appreciate you for who you continue to be. Thank you for being God. We come to you blessing your name. We come to you with hands lifted, surrendering ourselves to you, because we trust and believe that we owe you everything and our life belongs to you. You gave your life for us. Help us to give our lives to you also. I thank you, Lord, for what you're doing for each person that's watching this today. I pray, Lord, that you would do like the psalmist says, maker of heaven, Lord, maker of heaven and earth, bless us from Zion. Let the rain of your blessings fall on us. Your kingdom come. Your will be done. Your plans for us on earth as it is in heaven. We thank you, Lord, for all that you're doing. And I pray that you would cover us, you would keep us, and you would protect us. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you all. See you tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. as we start Psalm 135. God bless you. See you later.